This is from the Srimad Bhagavatam 5.5.18. Gurur na sasya, swajano na sasya, pita na sasya, janani na sasya, daivam na tatsya, napadisya sasya, namo chayedya samupeta mrityum. What is the translation? One who cannot deliver his dependents from the path of repeated birth and death should never become a spiritual master, a relative, a father, a husband, a mother, or a worshipable demigod. Just yesterday, one boy, he was messaging me from India, Gurgaon. So he is saying that he wants to become brahmachari, but his parents are not allowing. They think that, oh, he is escaping from responsibilities and just, you know, becoming a so-called sadhu. Many, almost all parents whose children want to actually join Krishna consciousness think like this. Whereas their actual duty as parents is to make the devotees and children into devotees of Krishna. But when the children actually become devotees, they think this is, he became a rascal. He's brainwashed. When some sadhu comes, they will request for blessings. When own son becomes sadhu, he is a rascal. This is the mentality of materialistic people. They do not understand what the aim of life is. What is the meaning of running away from responsibility? Just because you did not marry, did not produce children, this is responsibility? Is the only responsibility? It is said, the six Goswamis, Tyaktva Turnam Asesha Mandala Patim Sada Puchavat. The Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami, big, big people in the society. Not ordinary people. But they gave up all that position, prestige, everything they have given up and became mendicants, sadhus, just with one cloth. That's it. Not much position, nothing. Just living under a different tree every night. Not even attached to the same tree. Sometimes attachment does not mean big, big bungalow, big, big car, nothing. It can be just a simple tree. Oh, I want to sleep under the same tree every day. That is also attachment. So they used to sleep under a different tree every night. They were prime ministers of Nawab Hussain Shah, king. Yeah, very highly qualified. The prime minister, the king did not want them to leave. Arrested them when they wanted to leave. They escaped the prison and ran away. Even Raghunath Das Goswami was the son of a Majumdar landlord. And it is said that that landlord, what is this, Hiranya and Govardhan Majumdar, the two brothers. Hiranya Majumdar is the father of Raghunath Das Goswami and his brother Govardhan Majumdar. So they both were so rich that their riches could be compared with Indra. They have heaps and heaps of gold, almost limitless wealth. But his son wanted to become a sannyasi. And they tried to capture him in so many ways. He employed 12 bodyguards, not to protect his son from enemies, but to protect his son from running away. So this was the situation. Now, this is all not running away from responsibility, because Tyaktva Tornam Asesha Mandalapatim Sada Tuchava, they have given up all the royal opulence. But what they have done, Lokanam Hita Karano Tribhuvane. So for the sake of the whole world, they have given up this tiny world of family life. Now they have accepted as their family the entire world and all the people. See, what is a family? We care so much for our family members. If something happens to some other member of another family, we you know, feel compassion, but we don't do as much as we do for our own family members. But a person, a devotee, Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, the whole world is his family. Because he understands, as Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, Sarva Yonishu Kaunteya, chapter 14, verse 4. Murtaya Sambhavantiya Tasam Brahma Mahadyonir Aham Bija Pradahpita. It should be understood that all species of life, O son of Kunti, are made possible by birth in this material nature, and that I am the seed-giving father. So Krishna is saying, I am the father of all species of life. So everybody is his children. So we are all one family in that sense. Actually, we are all one family. We think we are, oh, this is my family, that's your family, that's your family. So I only care for my family. But a devotee who gives up this tiny family accepts the whole world as his family and tries to help everybody. Suppose some younger brother is suffering with some difficulty, whether financial or this way, that way, health wise, whatever. Then the siblings will help, right? This is natural, unless there is some big fight and they don't see each other's faces. Otherwise, they will help. Similarly, a devotee is called Paradukha Dukhi. He is very much miserable to see others miserable. For his own accord, there is no misery for devotee. Because he is happy in Krishna consciousness, serving Krishna, no problem. But he feels so much misery when he looks at others. Oh, they are suffering so much. How can I let them suffer? Let me help them. Just like an elder brother would help his younger brother. Like that. He thinks the whole world has to be helped. He knows the answer for their suffering. That is the thing. It's not that he is trying to figure out what's the solution. Oh, this person is suffering from this problem. Okay, let us figure out something. Let us invent something. No, he is not speculating. He knows what is the crux of the whole problem. The suffering, all sufferings are because of forgetfulness of Krishna. That's it. There is no doubt about it. For those who doubt that, they are not conversant with actual knowledge. But those who know, they know what is the solution. Oh, they have disobeyed Krishna. They have refuted or denied Krishna's shelter. And now they are suffering. They don't need to suffer. As Krishna said, I am the father. If Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the richest person, is the father, why we children of the richest father are suffering? This we must ask. Because we have purposely gone away from him. If a rich man's son goes on the street and does not care for his father, then one day he will be begging on the street. But if he just agrees to come back to his father, then everything is solved. He does not need to go anywhere else to find his livelihood, life or anything. He just has to agree to his father. Because of the disagreement, now he is away. Who asked him not to come back to his father? The father is waiting. When he will come back to me? Just like now, this brahmachari, not yet brahmachari, he wants to become brahmachari. He contacted me, he said, like this, my father is, doesn't want me to go. Similarly, Krishna is our real father, he does not want us to go out from him. Which father I want to listen to? That is the question. His father is my father only for this life. And it's an illusory relationship, it's not actually father. It's a material relationship. Yes, it is not that we don't respect or I don't care. Not like that. But our eternal relationship is with Krishna. And he and I and everybody in this world, we are all servants of Krishna. This has to be understood. So if some material father is not allowing the son to go and become devotee of Krishna, then he is in the wrong. Because his duty is to make his son devotee of Krishna. Just like Prahlad Maharaj, everybody knows Bhakta Prahlad, he disobeyed his father. His father was saying, no, you cannot chant Narayana, you must chant Hiranya. Hiranyakashipu, my name you must chant, I am God. Prahlad Maharaj, no, I will chant Narayana, I will continue to chant Narayana, whatever you say. So, that kind of disobedience, is exalted, is worshipable. One time, we went to one group of devotees, we all went for, Tirthyatra, pilgrimage. So, we went to Simhachalam, the Narasimha deity, very nice, Varaha Narasimha, nice temple and everything. So, we took darshan, everything nicely, came down. We had to do something in the bank. some transfer of money, my brother's, because my brother also stays in the Philippines. So his Indian bank account had to be, I think the card had to be changed. Something was there, some issue was there. Some money had to be transferred somewhere. So anyway, so his account was in State Bank of India. And we went to State Bank of India after coming down from the hill. So at the foothill there was this bank branch. So we went there. So it was a difficult situation because many years he hasn't used that account, something like that. So then we just, out of, you know, the bank manager, he was trying to help us see if any way can we help. So we just, out of custom, we just said, okay, our father was also in the State Bank of India. Actually, that's a fact. So my father, whole life, he just worked in State Bank of India. So he retired. So we just told that, mentioned that. Then he said, oh, fine, then good, you know, he must be having an account, so this can be done, you know, we can transfer to his account, and from his account, we can transfer to another account, whatever it was. So then, we like lightly regretted why we told her, because we joined up Krishna consciousness, so our father also was in disagreement. So since then, there was no communication. So we told, don't be too excited because we can't really contact our father like that. He won't be agreeable to help us in any way. So, said, why? No, we have joined this movement, so that's why. Huh? What is the use of your studying Vedas and all this? Huh? If you can't respect your father. Huh? What is the use? You people are all cheaters. Bank manager immediately. So, of course, my brother, he said, sir, this is Simachalam. This is where Prahlad Maharaj is worshipped. And he disobeyed his father. Because his father asked him not to become devotee. We are not saying that our father is Renunciant, but anybody who is not allowing their children to, you know, join and surrender to Krishna. Sorry. If he is strong enough, he can just go ahead. Sometimes, I mean, how many times it has happened that for some girl, this boy, you know, rejects the family and everything and goes? Okay, that is bad. But for God? You know? So, they don't see like this. Then he do not know what to say. Because he is sitting in Simhachalam, where Prahlad Maharaj is worshipped every day. For disobeying his father and obeying Krishna. And he is asking us, why you are worshipping Krishna if you cannot obey your father? This is the irony. So sometimes, therefore, we, in the lives of great saintly people, we always find this kind of disobedience. But it is not really disobedience. It is actually helping them. Because it is said, later Narasimhadev said, you see this, what happened? After Hiranyakashipu was killed by Narasimhadev, Narasimhadev asked Prahlad Maharaj, please, you ask for me, from me, any benediction that you want. What do you want? I want to give you something. Then Prahlad Maharaj said, I am not a businessman. I am not worshipping you for something, getting something in return. I don't want anything. I just want your service, that's all. I want to be able to serve you always. He said, no, it's my wish that I want to give you something, you ask. Then he said, alright, if you really want to give me something, then you give mukti to my father, because he was always against you. He must be in hell now. So you please deliver him, give him moksham. See, how much he cared for his father actually. It's not that he did not care for his father, he cared. But that does not mean obedience to somebody who is doing wrong. Just like the father cares for the child, does not mean that the child is always asking chocolate, he will give him. Like that he will have worms in his stomach. Just because he does not agree with the son, does not mean that he does not care for the son. Similarly, when one is a devotee, he is like an older person, vriddha. Vriddha means old. There are two kinds of old age. One is by age and one is by wisdom. So even if one is young, if he is advanced in knowledge, especially not a PhD, this kind of knowledge is useless. We are talking about knowledge about spiritual life. He is called also called Vriddha. That's why Sukadeva Goswami was speaking Bhagavatam. He was only 16 years old. And big rishis who were thousands and thousands of years old were sitting there and listening to him. He was only 16 years old. And that Bhagavatam we are reading today now. This shloka is from that Bhagavatam which Sukadeva Goswami spoke. So Vriddha does not depend on age. Just because somebody has more experience in life does not mean he knows more. How we know more is from understanding from God. What is the truth? Krishna is explaining in Bhagavad Gita. What is what? So if we understand from Bhagavad Gita, then we are advanced in knowledge. Not just by personal experience. What if our whole life was experiencing a wrong thing? Actually, there is a fact. Whole life there, people are experiencing their own life based on their own bodily concept. After 60, 70, 80 years old, still they are thinking, I am the body. So what is the wisdom that they have? This is not to disrespect, but this is talking facts. So this is the thing. So anyway, he asked for moksha for his father. You see what Narasimhadev said. Shri Bhagavan Vacha, Tri Saptabhir Pita Puta, Pitrabhir Sahate Nakha, Yat Sadhosya Kule Jato Bhavanvai Kulapavana. The Supreme Personality of Godhead said, my dear Prahlad, O most pure, O great saintly person, your father has been purified along with 21 forefathers in your family. Because you were born in this family, the entire dynasty has been purified. This is the way a devotee helps his family, even though he leaves the family. Just because he being born in the family, 21 generations of his family, not only of father, 21 generations of family are being liberated. And in the purport, Prabhupada explains, the word Tri Saptabhir means 7 multiplied by 3. In one's family, one can count back 4 or 5 generations to one's great-grandfather or even one's great-grandfather's father. But since the law mentions 21 forefathers, this indicates that the benediction expands to other families also. Before the present family in which one has taken birth, one must have been born in other families in a previous life, you know. Thus, when a Vaishnava takes birth in a family, by the grace of the Lord, he purifies not only that family, but also the families of his previous births. See how much Krishna is doing for the devotee. How you can say that he is running away from responsibility? He is taking up more responsibility than the others who are not doing anything in devotional service. He can have a family, he can have, you know, after that what? What is the meaning of the word Putra? Why the son is called Putra? It is an acronym in Sanskrit. Pu stands for Pun Nama Naraka. Pun, there is a Naraka, a hell called Pun, where one is boiled alive, like Kumbhipa. Then, Tra stands for Trayate, or release, delivered from. So, Punnama Naraka Trayate Iti Putra. Putra is one who saves his father from going to hell. That is why the sons, they do for their departed ancestors who are Pindadan. Pinda, they offer every year. This is Vishnu Prasadam. He is being offered to the departed soul once a year. Our 1 year is equal to their 1 day in Pitraloka. So that means every day that soul is receiving Vishnu Prasadam. And as long as he keeps on receiving this, he will never fall down to hell. He will stay in Pitraloka, enjoying heavenly opulences. This is the reason for begetting children, to save himself from going to hell. But if the Putra does not do that, those who are karmis, if they do once a year, that's one thing. But what if the son has dedicated his life and every day he is offering offering the naivedyam to Vishnu or Krishna and distributing the prasad and eating prasadam, and not only prasadam, whole life is dedicated for Krishna. How much the family members are glorified? So this understanding should be there. One should not fear, oh, I will lose my son. Or you will lose your son anyway. Either by death or by disagreement or whatever. You are going to lose him anyway. What if the, when the son goes overseas study, oh, they proudly say, my son is in Canada, you know, studying big masters. Then he is away from you, right? Why are you not crying? That is okay. If son is in Canada, US, that is okay. But if son becomes in the ashram, in the same village also, he is a rascal. Just because, oh, he is not with us. This is the Maya. Maya, simply in talking nonsense in the head. Because we are haunted by Maya, we think like this. So, a devotee is very, to become a devotee is very fortunate, and if somebody has devotee in their family, they are so fortunate. We also must become devotees. Then we will understand the whole truth. Then we will not, there will be no disagreement. Like his family, his mother gladly sent him. Prabhu's mother also gladly wanted him to become sannyasi even. My mother also completely agreeable for me to become. Only my father was not agreeing. But his father, mother, everybody is agreeing. That is proper standard. That is proper understanding of family life. Real family is that. Not that, you know, oh, I'll keep my son for myself. How long are you going to keep? Either you're going to die, or the son is going to die, or the son is going to go away with a girl, or you're going to study, or you're going to work in some other country. You're not going to be with him. It's just a few years when he's a kid, that's it. After that, you're not going to be there anyway. Why this unnecessary? This is our contamination.